Right now, LG&D crews are still working to restore power to a few customers still in the dark. WLKY's Gary Parker is live in St. Matthews with that story. Gary?
Natasha, good afternoon. LG&E utility crews were here just a half an hour ago. They were working at this neighborhood on Kentucky Avenue. And the reason, if we could just zoom in the background right here, we could see that fallen tree limb, which had caused an outage in at least one of the homes. And LG&E crews are saying that they are working on those last few customers that are without power.
You can look around and see all these old trees that's just literally growed up high. And don't take much of a wind to tear them down.
And that was one of the residents living in this neighborhood. Crews worked on Kentucky Avenue in St. Matthews, restoring power to one remaining house without power. And the cause, again, that fallen tree limb. Now, yesterday, severe thunderstorm came quick, but it made a big mark. LG&E says 6,000 were left in the dark at the height of the storm, and there were two reports of house fires caused by lightning bolts, one at a home in Prospect and another in Shively. Now, there's also flash flooding and downed trees across Jefferson County. Jefferson County Public Schools also delayed releasing elementary students. Utility crews worked all night and were able to get that number of customers without power from the thousands to less than 100 by 7 o'clock this morning. And an LG&E spokesperson talked about what it took for crews to get that power back on quickly.
Based on the number of customers affected by that outage, and then they'll also look for areas that may be, say, law enforcement agencies or emergency services.
And LG&E reports on their website that there are 84 customers still left without power at this hour. Now, the spokesperson from LG&E also added that some of those people without power may not be related to the actual storm. Reporting live in St. Matthews, Gary Parker, WLKY News.